Fidget spinners, they seem fun. They seem harmless, but according to the Russian government, they are not. They are addictive. There is a Russian watchdog group that says fidget spinners are not just a fad. Ask any ballpoint clicker. I don't even know what that means. They say that fidget spinners often have a negative effect on the psyche and make a person susceptible to manipulation, according to a show called Virus on Rossiya 24's television. They said it's an instrument of zombifying and a form of hypnosis. They said the Life News pro-Kremlin news site, according to The Guardian, ran a feature on, quote, seven tragedies that happened to children because of spinners, including a six-year-old boy who got one stuck on his finger. You have a lot of these, yes?
I have five. My nephew gave me five. I have three that glow in the dark.
Good.
And they light up, and two that light up. So they say that they're hypnosis, they're manipulative. Mm-hmm. So are cell phones. So there's millions of those in the world. I don't think that fidget spinners audience are a problem.
Here's why they're a problem.
Why are they a problem, Brett?
Because everybody makes it look so easy to spin it and then put it on your forehead or your nose and it keeps spinning. But if you even make a fraction of a mistake, it's gonna smack you in the eyeball.
But that's, I mean,
like six times in a row.
That's a personal issue that you need to deal with, B, because
it is.
I mean, why are you putting them on your face anyways?
Because I saw other people do it and I was like, I can do that stuff. But I got mine at 7-Eleven. I have three. I got them for the main show, the Young Turks main show, and to hand them out when we were doing the story. And the ones I got at 7-Eleven were like kind of broken. So when everyone else has the ones that spin flawlessly in perfect equilibrium, mine are like kind of like shimmying as I hate it.
You got them from 7-Eleven though.
Where do you get yours?
Mine came from Amazon.com.
Oh God, they're so
good.
And
they were delivered in 2 days. It was awesome. Did you ever play Pogs growing up?
Hell yeah.
So I remember when-
Bandit Chaminade.
They were banned, and my sister played Pogs at her school too. You cannot play Pogs because teachers thought it was like this new thing that was going to make kids stupid.
Gang related, they called it at my-
How was it gang related?
No reason, they just thought everything was gang related. It was the 90s.
Yeah.
For those of you who don't know, Pogs are little cardboard circles. They're like milk caps, and so you would put them face down, and then you had a heavier one, and you would slam it down, and it would try to flip them over.
Right.
And if you flip them over, people would win them. There's fads. There have been fads throughout the centuries. This is one of them. And I saw one online, a fidget spinner that was a switchblade with a fidget spinner in the middle. So a pocket knife that flipped out. So you would spin it, and then when you were done spinning, you'd flip the knife out. That's actually dangerous.
Right, and that's an isolated incident. And then all the incidences that are in the article about seven people and the kid with his finger cut on it, that doesn't happen daily. You know, I don't feel like there's an urgency or a need to do a study on these things. It's just a waste of time and people's money and energy. This doesn't make any sense. Fidget spinners, they're very soothing. I actually like holding it. It's a very soothing, it's like stress balls.
Yep.
You know,
you scrunch them.
Right.
Work your forearm.
I mean, it's just people have their own little tics, and I think that this just caught on with kids and they're creative. There's some really pretty fidget spinners.
I want the ones that light up. I want one of those. I want one that, mine's a triangular shape. I want one that's a quad. I want four.
You want instead of three?
Instead of three, I want them all. And I want them now. And I want different sizes, but they cost money. And I know that if I have that collection, it would be worthless in like 6 weeks. And I'd have to keep them for 60 years for them to be worth money again.
Right.
But yeah, do you play with them?
I you know, so when I'm at home watching TV, I have one on my nightstand. Sometimes, just depends. I mean, my nephew gave them to me, so I mean, I just because he gave them to me, I use them. But I mean, they're like I said, they're soothing, they're comforting. It's cool. I think it's the rotation of it that's soothing for me, feeling it spin, I guess.
Yeah, it just is almost like a perpetual motion. I enjoy it. There's like mine does vibrate a little bit, so it kind of relaxes my hand.
Yeah.
I love it. What do you guys think? Do you have a fidget spinner? And how does it affect you as a person?
Does it make you manipulative or a zombie?
Barron Trump has one. He had one on the steps of Air Force One. They're everywhere. What do you think? Give us your thoughts, and we'll see you next time on Pop Trigger.